This Women's Month, ANZ puts a spotlight on remarkable women in Philippine society. Dateline Philippines talked to Marga Ortigas, a book author who found her true calling after an eventful 25-year career as a foreign correspondent. She recently shared the life lessons she learned in her news career. In her book, There Are No Falling Stars in China. A sequel to her debut novel, The House on Calle Sombra, is currently in the works. Ortigas admits she had doubts in every step of her journey, but she trusted her gut and pushed through.
I think it's really the fear. It's the fear that is our biggest traitor. I think we are so fearful to veer off the path that we have been told to be on that we chain ourselves often to the unhappiness of not just ourselves, but the people around us. And at the end of the day, I can't necessarily say this is what I had planned for myself, but I learned that even in the best of times, sometimes life has other plans for us that turn out better than we ourselves could have ever imagined. So I think I just learned to go with the flow and release fears very early on.
Australia also expressing concern following Manila and Beijing's recent maritime incident. Prime Minister Anthony Albanese cited the need for countries to abide by the United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea, or UNCLOS. Albanese earlier reaffirmed his government's commitment to strengthening maritime cooperation with Southeast Asia.
I am very concerned, and Australia is concerned, about any unsafe and destabilising behaviour in the South China Sea. It is dangerous, and it creates risks of miscalculation, which can then lead to escalation. So we would call upon a number of nations, emphasised in their statements. The foundation document is UNCLOS, the UN Convention of the Law of the Sea. That is something that should be the guide for all nations' participation.
Here at home, the Health Department is ramping up preparations to mitigate any health-related effects of El Nino. Rafael Bozzano joins us on the line for more. Raf?
Hi, Ron. It's not just the agriculture industry preparing for El Nino. Hospitals are also bracing for the effects of a strong climate phenomenon in terms of ensuring water supply, which is a resource essential to the daily operations of medical facilities. At the sidelines of the inauguration of the country's first urgent care and ambulatory service facility in Santo Tomas, Pampanga, Health Secretary Ted Herbosa said that he has also formed an El Nino task force within the agency to specifically oversee and guide health facilities during the climate phenomenon. Hospitals have been instructed to come up with their own preparedness plans to ensure water and electric supply are not interrupted. This, as many hospital procedures rely heavily on a steady flow of water. The Jose Bilingan Memorial Hospital, which serves as Central Luzon's regional hospital, is among the many facilities gearing up for the anticipated effects of El Nino. With several water sources in place, it's not leaving anything to chance. It is also set up to additional elevated water tanks on top of its current water sources, which can store 695 cubic meters of water, good for 3 days. Aside from heat-related illnesses, the health chief also reminds the public to be wary of other diseases that may become prevalent during El Nino. Among these are water and vector-borne diseases. Vector-borne diseases like dengue are also common during El Nino, as the public stores water in open containers, which may serve as breeding sites for mosquitoes. Hospitals, according to Herbosa, have been advised to begin training personnel, particularly emergency medicine doctors, to better respond to various illnesses the public may experience at the height of the devastating effects of El Nino. Back to you, Ron.
Rafael Bozzano with that story. Thanks, Raf.